Hey everybody. Hey, I just kind of wanted to give a quick update on like the impact that Scott and Nora have had on me during the time that I've been part of Strong Confident Living, which honestly has probably been around 3 months or so once COVID hit. Kind of a backstory, and maybe to kind of give kind of credit as to why it's so powerful and why I think this way about their group is. This is the first time in my life I've ever done any type of a high intensity interval training. Generally, you can find me in the gym and I'm lifting heavy stuff up and putting heavy stuff back down. That's what I do. I lift weights for physique and I train muscle groups, and cardio is kind of a one day and for about an hour just to kind of get my heart rate up and sweat a little bit. But when COVID hit, I really didn't know what I was going to do. And my friend Marcos Binder, who had been talking about them for quite a while now, said, "Hey, you ought to try them out, right? Try one of the workouts." And so I did. And it was really unique because I thought, "Oh, I'll do it for a little bit. We'll see what happens." And my thinking was, it's cardio, right? It's kind of high intensity cardio. Maybe I'll get some benefit. That'll be great. But if anything, I'll be okay, right? And then let me get back in the gym and lift stuff. But when COVID hit, I basically sat for a couple of weeks, and I have a voracious appetite. My calorie content's probably around 3,000 calories a day, and I'm very thin. But I need to build muscle, right? I need to feed the muscle. And so for those couple of weeks, it went straight to my belly. And I said, "Oh crap, I'm gaining some serious weight very quickly, and I don't do that." Long story short, over the last 3 months, I've done like the 44 Summer Slim Down, which I'm about to complete on Saturday. I've done some of their other workouts. I've done some of Scott's, his FU50. I thought that's kind of neat. 50 reps every day, and I get to do something. But the result is looking down now, I have lost weight, and my physique is insane. I am cut beyond belief. I have this amazing abs that you can see very clearly. And not to be, I try to stay PG, that my girlfriend definitely enjoys this. But it's much more, right? It's much more than just 30 minutes a day, 6 days a week, one day rest. Marcos and I get on Zoom and just sweat, yell at each other, and see what happens. It has impacted me mentally and in a very positive way. I suspect I'm not the only one here, but for the last 3 months, in a way, I've been stuck here in a house, right, staring at walls. And generally, I'm a very normal people person, and I like being around people. I have groups outside of my life that I hang out with a bunch of people, and I haven't seen any of them, right? And that separation, and it can get very depressing, right? Get very taxing. And interesting enough, what I have found is that through strong, confident living mindset, what they do, how they provide, honestly, more than just a service, it has kept me very positive through this, really upbeat, where I can deal with this on a day-to-day. It's been really amazing. Like, a lot of my friends are out of their minds, depressed, going, "I don't really care. I'm going outside. I don't care if people get sick. Just get me out of the house," right? And it has helped me deal with this, right? Mentally, right? It has nothing to do with, doing a push-up or planks or, get-ups or, knee-ups. It doesn't really, that is in a very important part, but the mental and the emotional impacts have been like nothing that I would have expected, And I was wrong. I was completely wrong when I thought what I would get out of this, because what I got out of this is much greater than I would have ever expected. Again, like I said, I thought, I'll work out a little bit every single day. It'll just kind of maintenance where I'm at, and then I'll get back in the gym, and I'll lift eventually. Well, I'm not back at the gym, and I'm loving this. Like, I work out 25 minutes, and I am a soaking, sweaty mess. Like, this isn't a game for me, right? This has been a lifestyle for years, and I have this new thing that honestly I really didn't know what to expect. I mean, it's the honest truth, and it is much more. It is much more than watching Scott very push, positive, push, positive. And it's interesting that he understands these in such a way that he knows where at least I can't speak for you, but for I, is things that we'll do wrong during the exercise, right? Keep your chin up, do this, put your elbows over your hands during planks. And I can hear him talking about this, and I will find myself correcting my form until, into the second and third week of doing this. My form is in really great shape. I can see improvements. I can see that I'm getting through this without, dying on the ground going, I really hate this. It's fun to listen. Honestly, Laura in the background, when she gets quiet or she starts squealing, going, oh, good God, I hate this, or to hear her, push through it. It gives me that motivation and drive to keep pushing, right? This has been amazing. I can honestly tell you, like, I just had a team meeting with my coworkers and my boss. We do this every Thursday from the lab, and I'm telling them about you guys. And I'm telling them, like, look, this is a benefit, right? And at any time, this is a benefit. But for right now, in the place that all of us are at, the uncertainty, the danger. I mean, I'm a scientist, right? I live in a lab. This is what I do for a living. I look at facts, I look at logic, and I put data together to interpret what does it mean and apply it to a bigger picture. And I look at everything, right? Working out is the same way. And what they have is something amazingly special. And what's even better is what if you listen by listening to Scott and Laura, I don't. You don't. It's you don't get the sales call that I could pick that up in a heartbeat, right? I've been a professional chef, I've been a statistician, and I'm a food scientist right now, and I can pick up a sales call in a heartbeat. And I don't get that. Like, what you get is the real deal, right? What you get, what I see from Scott and Laura is this is it. Like, you can see the passion, you can see the enjoyment, you can see that this is what they want to do. Bravo. Like, holy shit, this is great. I could talk forever. I won't lie. I could talk forever about the benefits of this. My own personal benefit. Like, when I started, I thought, how the hell do you guys do this? Like, I'm dying after like the warm up. I'm going, holy crap, my body hurts. My legs, I can't lift them. Now I'm like, shit, let's do it, It's much greater. I've listened in on some of their mindset stuff, and go off on kind of a quick tangent. I'm in groups where I go help people, right? I'm not gonna go into the specifics, but I help people. I help people change their perspective of reality, how to think about things. And what I love, especially with Laura, is all those topics that she goes through, all those specifics. This is it, right? Change your perspective and everything follows, right? The short version is it's all between the ears, right? The hardest thing is to make the decision. Once I make the decision and I'm going to do it, it doesn't matter. I've already fought with myself about why do I want to do this? How do I focus on getting through the roadblocks, right? How do I get over it? How do I get through it? How do I go around it? Think about it. And I love this about Scott and Laura. I'm not kidding when I say, God, I would love to be able to, when this is over, to be able to move to Malibu and say, let's train, right? Let's train in person. Let's pick up some weights and see what we can do. Let's go into competitions. Like, what they have given me is another blueprint on how to live life. That's the end of it, right? It's not just I'm going to do a plank, which Scott absolutely loves beyond belief, and I hate these things. I still do. What they do is amazing. What they do is such a service to people is it's incredible. And the fact that they love it and they enjoy it and you can see it, you can hear it goes without saying. So long story, hopefully I have not put you to sleep, but thank you. Thank you for an opportunity, at the very least to get through a very trying time. Because it's not over. I'm going to tell you, COVID-19 is not over. And we still have some stuff to go through. But I have now another tool in my bag to get me through the hard times. Like when I sit up and go, fuck, I don't want to do this anymore. I'm tired of staring at my walls. I'm tired of not being around people. I'm part of a community bigger than myself. And my last thing was this. What I love about you guys, all of you in this community, is how supportive you are of everybody. No one cares. No one cares what I look like. No one cares where I'm at in my journey. No one cares how weak or how strong I am, how much muscle I have or not, how cut I am, can I do a burpee or not. No one cares. It's keep get up, right? The support has been incredible and very surprising, right? Because I'm part of a very, very hardcore supportive worldwide group that is extremely supportive. And I would almost say that this is more. Like there is no, it's just pure acceptance, right? And everybody lifts everybody up. It's about the group and not the individual. So, kick ass. Thank you very much. And I'll see you tomorrow. Take care, guys.